Okay, we're going to talk about why I don't like shows and events where money's involved with horses. I'm not a show fan. I've said that in quite a few of my things. I don't like horse racing. I don't like rodeo sports. I don't like gymkhana. I don't like jumping horses for money. I don't like polo. They're all bad for the horse, and they all hurt a horse. And people do crazy things when they're trying to win a ribbon or an award. And some of the things I've heard over the years to me are just cruel and brutal. And yet most people in these sports don't even know it goes on, or they look the other way, or if they see it, they go, oh, that person's winning, maybe I'll do it too. So are there good horse people and horse women or horse men in sports? Sure. There's a few out there that go out there to learn, to take it as the experience, that don't necessarily try to win, that don't stake their whole reputation and ego on it. But there's also a lot of people that want to be trainers and want to be big name clinicians and want to get their name. And they got to build their I Love Me wall with all their pictures of all their winnings and all their fancy little ribbons when they were 12 years old, how they won in a competition. And, you know, basically to build a resume or to try and promote yourself so you can make money off the horse. These are the main reasons that I don't like shows and why I'm so anti-show. And there's a lot of people that do shows that just think that, you know, I don't know what I'm talking about, or I'm just negative, or I'm angry, or whatever you want to say. But I'm telling you, the things they do to horses in shows are just brutal, cruel, and criminal. One of the things that they do in shows is a thing called peppering or gingering. And that's where you rub ginger or pepper on underneath of a horse's tail, and it burns. But he looks good when he's running out there because he gets extra points. And the judge will think that he loves his job because he's out there and his tail is so high and pretty. And look how proud he is. He really loves that. He don't love nothing. His tail burns because some idiot human rubbed something that burnt him and has caused him pain and discomfort, so he can't put his tail down, because when he does, it burns and irritates. So what does he do? He holds his tail up. Now, of course, you got a bunch of stand of dummies, and you got a bunch of people that want to win ribbons that are out there, ooh, that horse loves his job. Look how proud he is. That horse ain't proud. He's hurting, because people are mean to him, and they've done cruel things to win a ribbon, to make a name for themselves, so they can say they're a good horse person, so they can say they're a good horseman, or they train their horse good. Those are cheats and things that just drive me nuts about shows, and they're so common, and people don't want to see them. They don't want to hear, oh, Rick, I've never seen that. You know, it just... Hi, Mr. T. I know, I got this camera out. It ain't going to get you. Those are things that, you know, people just don't want to see, and they want to tell me about how, oh, you know what, I've never seen that. You must have been in a bad area. Look, I've been in places from Texas to Oklahoma to... you know, North Carolina, California. I've seen some things done, and believe me, these things are not isolated. These are common horse tricks. And if you get in with the cliques, with the people that win, or somebody that's past that point in their life to where they don't want to win anymore, they'll tell you all these mean things that are being done to horses routinely. So you got gingering and pepper tail to make the tail high and big. Another thing they'll do is if a horse has a tail that's too active, you know, a judge will say, oh, that horse isn't having fun. He's not enjoying his job because his tail is swishy. His tail is usually swishy because he's getting beat or spurred or yanked around with a big bit. That's why his tail swishes, because he ain't happy. Well, instead of maybe trying to work on your horsemanship and get your horse to work better for you without pain or irritating him, what do people do? They cut the nerves to a horse's tail so he can't wag his tail. Now, to me, that's just brutal, criminal. I've got no patience for people like that. You take away the one main communication source of a horse, how he flashes his tail, how he communicates to other horses, how this horse talks and protects himself from biting flies, bees, and other things, and you cut the nerve so he can't wiggle his tail just so you can win a ribbon, so you can say that you're a good horse trainer or you're a good horseman. You know, and people go, oh, that doesn't happen. You must just be around people that you know, have done these bad things. I've never seen that. You've got your head in the sand if you've never seen it. You haven't been to a horse show and you haven't talked to people that won. You haven't had people that got out of horse shows for this exact reason. And I guarantee you people are going to put comments on this video about, I've seen what you've done and it is criminal and that's why I got out of it. Because I've talked to many people that tell me they got out of it for that reason. So you cut nerves to tail, or you put hot pepper or ginger on a horse's tail to make him look proud. Well, let's see, how else can I screw the horse up to make me look good? Well, if a horse pins his ears because he doesn't like the bit, or because they'll like get spurred, or he doesn't like to run around an arena until he's mind numb for 500 times so he can go out and win a ribbon, and to stop him from pinning his ears, I'll just cut the nerves to his ears. And that way he can't pin his ears. That way his ears will always look up. And then I'll have some judge on the sideline that knows I cut his ears, but because he looks good for the crowd and because he's the only one that didn't pin his ears, we'll give him the medal and the award and say that horse enjoys his job. Look, he doesn't pin his ears. All these other horses are pinning their ears. This one didn't pin his ears. So we'll just cut his nerves, another main communication source for a horse. So he can't talk to another horse. They've done studies in the wild, and when a horse is born with nerve damage or something in the ears and he can't communicate, he gets beat up, killed, pushed out of herd, and doesn't live very long. Because he doesn't understand how to communicate to horses. He can't tell another horse when to get away. He can't tell another horse that he's dominant. He cannot communicate with horses, so he ends up getting isolated. And when he gets isolated, he either gets eaten, or he can't keep up with a herd, or he doesn't get food, or he's out on his own, and he's nervous, and he can't sleep, so he ends up dying. So what do we do when we domesticate them? We cut the nerves so they can't talk to another horse, and they can't communicate, and basically just cut their ears so they can't talk, so I can win a stinking medal or a ribbon. Yeah, I just love sports. You get these horses that dance around with their feet, and they're looking all proud, and people are like, oh, look at those Pasifinos. Oh, they got good breeding. That horse is so good, because look at he bounces his feet. You know, you get a horse to bounce their feet, you tape marbles under his foot, so every time the poor horse takes a step, it pounds into his soul, and it hurts him. So he pulls his foot up fast, and he keeps his head up high because he's in pain, and he dances around because it hurts. And then somebody's going to tell me, oh, that horse is, wow, that guy's a good trainer. Oh, that horse has good breeding. Look how it bounces, you know. Oh, look at that horse with his tail all up and proud. He's got good bloodlines. I want the same dad and mom he had. Let me go get us a papered horse just like him, so my horse. And meanwhile, you know, he's got ginger on his tail, or he's got marbles in his foot, or his ears have been cut, or the nerves in his tail's been cut, so he's quite. You know, and you got all these crazy things that go on. Another thing they do is they squirt a poor horse with a fire hydrant or a fire extinguisher that makes a loud noise and scares the crap out of a horse before he goes out to show. Why? Because it makes a horse nervous. He gets nervous. When a horse gets nervous, he puffs up. He gets big. He goes into fight or flight. He looks bigger. He's stronger. Oh, well, so what? I scare the crap out of my horse with a stinking fire extinguisher. You know what? I might win a ribbon. I'll just scare the crap out of the horse. I'll cut his nerves to his ears so he can't communicate, point his ears at me, and can't communicate with other horses. I'll cut his tail so he can't get a biting fly. But you know what? I get to win a ribbon. I get to pin that on a wall and tell everybody what a great person I am because I did all these crazy things. Of course, nobody's ever going to tell you they do those things to win, because normally after they do it and they win, they probably feel like an idiot, which they should. That they took abuse. You know, you go to these shows out here and you see, Mr. D, are you pushing me? All right, I'm going to go this way. You probably won't come because you're going to go to Buddy. So another thing they'll do is they'll tie, you know, you see a horse in these reining shows or whatever, and you see this horse pinning that back foot, and they're doing spins, and boy, that back foot is just planted to the ground, and he doesn't raise that foot, and people are like, wow, that horse has good breeding. That's a good horse, man. That's a good horse train. Whoever trained that horse, you know how you get a horse, another trick to get a horse to pin his foot? Is you put a boot on a horse's foot and you put a piece of barbed wire in there and you strap the boot around the barbed wire so it digs into the horse's leg. Then you tie a string to that barbed wire and you yank it every time the horse picks that foot up. And because it hurts and it stabs into his leg, the horse plants his foot to the ground trying to get away from the pain. And if you do it enough, pretty soon the horse won't pick that back foot up. And he leaves it planted in the ground. And he's learned. And some cowboy will tell you, well, that's how you train a horse. They got to learn. You got to show them who's boss and teach them respect. And by God, you got to take this horse by the reins. And you know what? That's why I don't like horse things. You know, polo, you watch a polo event, you watch those poor horses with their mouth. You go to a racing event, and they're shocking the horses before they go out there to get them jacked up and to get their adrenaline and endorphins going. You go to rodeo, they're shocking bucking horses to make them buck. And then you got people out there saying, this horse is bucking so good because he's got good breeding. He's the best breeding around. If you want a good bucking horse, buy from me. $10,000 because my horse is... That horse ain't breeding, ain't got nothing to do with it. He just got 12,000 votes up his butt. That's why he's bucking. That's why it doesn't look good. Anything done in a compulsion with a horse is like whipping a dancer. And I've got that saying on my Cowboy Wisdom page somewhere, but it's, you know, you don't get beauty out of pain and suffering. There's nothing pretty about a horse with his tail up because you put ginger or spice on it. There's nothing pretty about a horse that doesn't pin his ears because you cut him. So that's why I don't like shows. Hopefully that helps. You know, if you don't believe this happens, well, then you're living in la-la land. And that's why I'm not a show fan, and those are bad things done to horses. Hope that helps.